Hey, Earth people. Yeah, this guy does a pretty good job with this little cold here. You'll hear I've got the sound put down on this. And the name of this is, well, I'm not going to give you the name because then you'll go find it and start hating on the woman. Because the woman owns it, and she taught it how to buck because she's scared of the horse. Rick, how can you say that? I'm taking a guess. It's called an educated guess. Guided by experience and training and knowledge of horses and people, and we'll call it a swag, a swinging wild ass guess. And I'm telling you, this woman is scared of this horse and taught it to buck. So she went out and got a young cowboy who wasn't afraid to ride a bucking horse. People like to do to me when I was younger. Yo, Rick, can you, my horse, can you come ride him? Can you? All right. So this guy came out here, and he's going to pretty much fix this bucking problem in about 8 minutes of a video. And it won't be fixed completely, but you'll notice the horse will stop bucking. So, of course, she's told him that... Let me go ahead and turn this down because it gets kind of loud with the wind noise. So his round pinning is kind of okay. He's kind of abrupt on his cutoffs and his change. Puts a little bit of pressure there, making that horse run, because the horse is getting tired. So he's wearing the horse out. Why is he wearing the horse out? Because the horse will have less energy to buck if he's tired. So, you know, when you get a lot of the piss and vinegar out of a horse out, he's got less energy. Now, women who teach horses to buck tend to be lazy, tend not to be very active, tend to think it's too much work to run a horse around. The horse learns this. The horse learns how to avoid the nagging woman who does a lot of talking but not a lot of moving, and so the horse never gets tired. And then the woman gets tired of trying to make the horse tired, so they get on the horse when it's fresh, and then the horse bucks them off. And then they say the horse has a bucking problem, and they call someone else to fix it because it's the stupid horse's fault. This guy ran this horse around the ground pen for a couple minutes, got some piss and vinegar out of him, so even if he does buck, it's not going to be as hard and as strong, and the horse isn't one I'm going to do it as long because he's tired. That's how you get... Now, a good thing about what this guy's doing here is he's got the horse in a rope halter with rope reins. No bit, nothing in his mouth. Nothing that causes horse pain. Again, I'm going to take another swag here. This woman who owns a horse, because it's pretty in his paint, and somewhere in a video she goes, his or her cow breeding bloodlines is just crazy good. Because women are impressed by bloodlines and breeds, and then they wonder why they can't handle a horse that was bred to work hard 8 hours a day on cattle. And they ride it on a weekend in a show ring and wonder why the horse has all this pent-up activity, and they keep it locked up and they feed it high grain food, and then they wonder why the horse is always amped up and throws them and they can't control it. It's very simple for somebody that understands all the concepts. It's a very difficult process for people who are caught up into looks and pretty and bloodlines and good looking gear. And I won pink ribbons when I was a kid, and I rode a horse at Walmart for a quarter when I was four, therefore I'm a horsewoman. All right, here we go. I like this guy. He gets up on the horse. He gives it a chance to buck. He gives it a chance to be resistive, and he sees whether he's got the horse's mind. He wore it out. If this horse would have bucked or tried to take off, he probably would have round pinned him again for two more minutes. Okay, you want to run? I'll run you in circles. I'll get you tired. I'll get rid of your will and desire to want to buck and run off. But the horse gave a little bit of resistance, raised the head, walked off a little bit, showed a little anxiety. And he got down. Perfect. He didn't give the horse a chance to blow up. Remember, I tell you people this all the time, when you're starting a horse, the best thing you can do when you get on a horse is get off a horse. So the horse just learned through pressure and release. Pressure, if I stand still, I get release of pressure. Pressure and release, done correctly. He does it again, hesitates, slowly brings his leg up to see if it's going to...
There's a lot of women in the horse world. I have a lot of videos to back up what I'm saying, but I know a lot of women will get their little rice paper feelings hurt and go crying that I'm picking on women.
But a lot of women get on a horse lazy. They don't lift their leg. They run their boot and leg and they hit the horse in the rear. And it usually causes the horse to learn that I'm going to get kicked in the rear every time this woman gets on me. So it gets anxious and it's ready to react. So when he rubs his leg over, watch how he does it. He lets him know it's there and then he brings it over and sets in a saddle softly. See that? He gave it a good little test with his leg. Because he's learned, after you work with a bunch of horses from a bunch of lazy people that call other people to train their horses because they screwed them up, you learn why they screw them up. They're lazy. They don't know. They're not aware of their body. They're too busy running their mouth thinking the horse understands the 10,000 words that they say. Good girl, good boy, good girl, I love you. Please don't buck. Please listen to me. Whoa, ho, ho, don't move. Stand still. Whoa. And they use that, and they wonder why they don't get results. This guy ain't saying nothing to the horse. I kind of talked through his little test here. Test, test, now I'm going over. Good job. This guy's been around horses. And it doesn't take me long. Ricky doesn't like him because he's not a girl. That's not why I like him. I like what he's doing. It's just like horses. They don't care what bathroom they use. They don't care about this social justice crap about who's powerful and who's strong and who's the smartest and who's, you know, you can't talk about that. They don't care. They care about what you do. This horse is figuring out this isn't the same person that's been doing all the stupid crap, making me buck, making me a so-called bad horse. Now this guy isn't doing this. Now the horse is relearning. He's thinking. He's figuring it out. So the horse wanted to walk off. He kind of stopped him softly. He didn't yank his head. He didn't rip his face off. He didn't get into a long conversation and dissertation about, don't you walk off on me. I'll show you who's boss. I'm in charge. Don't you disrespect me. Pirelli said I need to shake this rope if you do. I need to kick you. I need to run you in circles. I'm going to get my whip. See, none of that happened. The guy just simply picked up the reins and said, hey, don't walk off. Moved. Whoa. And you stopped. Now I'll get you to walk off. Good job.
Rick, you're just picking on because you don't like pain horses.
All right, whatever. A horse's beauty is their curse because women buy things on looks and women buy pretty horses. And they think a pretty horse equals a good, great horse. And when it's not good and great, they blame the horse because they don't look in the pretty mirror and see who's causing the bad horses. Who's causing the bad behavior. Now, he's taking a horse in small circles because if the horse wants to buck and I've got him in a small circle, it's harder for him to buck because I'm curling his body. I'm curling his body in a circle versus allowing him to ball up his body in a bucking position. Again, this guy doing a lot of things right. I don't like the way he kind of leans and pulls. He's given direction and everything. I would rather him have better hand control and keep his hands a little closer to the horse's head and reins. So I'm not a fan of when I see outstretched arms. Remember, he's way out of the 10-inch box. His hands aren't anywhere near the horn. He's way out here. Now, sometimes when you have a new horse you're trying to teach him, this hand out here can be an extra cue. And when you're working with a young horse, you may do this so the horse knows, oh, when I see the hand here, I'm going to get pulled. So if you're doing it intentionally and you know you're doing it, this is okay. But a lot of people do this out of habit and they don't understand that they have loud, wide, wild hands.
Notice he's keeping his other hand on the horn because he knows he's been told this horse is going to buck. Because the woman that owns it has taught it how to buck. So he changes directions, and actually the horse kind of gets back on his rear end and does a nice little turn. Watch him. He kind of locks the horse's head. The horse's front feet kind of stall, and his back feet have no problem but for him to drop the hips and pivot around on his front end. Watch this. Pretty good little horse here. Backs up, pivots on that rear end really well, then moves his front feet around. Nice job. By the way, the woman's filming. She does a good job keeping him in camera. Rick, you're always picking on what? I just said she did a good job keeping him on camera. When he's finished training this, hopefully she can make him a good sandwich. I had to say that because I know there's going to be somebody with their hair up. Ah, dude, you women are more important than the making sandwich. Oh, whatever, people. Get a freaking life.
Here she is. Kick her bum. Nope, there she goes.
Now, you notice the woman throws in, women are always smart after the fact. You know, I can't tell you the number of women, when I pass an exit, they're right, Johnny, on the spot. You just pass the exit. You couldn't tell me that before? Maybe you didn't know I was supposed to turn, and when you figured it out, suddenly you thought you would rain this knowledge on me. So this woman, suddenly, as soon as the horse bucks, see, I told you, I know my horse. I'm a good trainer. I know what I'm doing. Of course you know it's going to buck. Because it bucked with you and you taught it to buck. The problem is you don't know you taught it to buck. You don't know how to stop the bucking because you won't look in the mirror and see that you caused it. So you call someone else. And then when they get there, suddenly you're Johnny on the spot. And you're going to give them this great piece of information and advice.
She is. Kick her bum. Nope, there she goes.
So, this horse, I'm not too concerned about the bucking on the horse because it's kind of, I was kind of cracking on this woman, so I kind of missed the initial buck.
Kick her bum. Nope, there she goes.
Well, there she goes. Man, I'm smart. I should be a horse owner. Yeah, that's my horse. See, I know my horse. I told you, there she goes. The horse hasn't been taught that bucking isn't good. The horse has been taught every time it does that, the woman who owns me falls off. So it's learned that if I buck, the woman will either get off or fall off. So bucking has become a good thing for the horse. Why? Because a stupid human taught the horse. It wasn't not okay to buck. The stupid human didn't teach the horse that when you buck, you work harder. And bucking doesn't get you anything but a lot more activity. Because most women will not get in a round pen like this and ride this buck out and wear this horse out. This horse, I guarantee you, is getting ridden more in this 8-minute video than the owner has ridden it probably since she owned it. Because every time she's tried to get on it, the horse moved or ran off. Every time she got on it and kicked the horse with her leg, the horse started bucking and she got off. If she ever did get on it, the horse immediately started bucking and she fell off. So the horse has learned to buck. The woman has learned that the horse bucks with her, but she hasn't connected that it's her fault and she caused it. So what does she do? She calls someone else out to fix her horse, to fix the horse's problem that she taught it. That is the huge, biggest problem in the horse world. So, he rides the buck good, and he kind of actually irritates the horse and kind of, makes it move. You want to buck? Let's buck. You want to buck? It ain't going to get into anything. See, the horse right now is like, holy shit. Usually when I buck, my stupid human falls off, and I get to go stand in the corner. And now, you hear the woman laughing. She thinks it's funny. See, it's funny. It's funny that you taught a horse to be this way and you taught a horse a bad lesson and you made the horse dangerous and you had to call someone else out to be hard on the horse to undo what you taught it. That's funny. Ha ha. That's so funny. That irritates me so freaking bad when I see women laughing about the dangers they put their horses in and the bad lessons they teach, and then it's funny. So, this horse stopped bucking. Why? Who knows why the horse stopped bucking? There's several reasons. One, it didn't get the desired result. The rider didn't fall off like normally when it bucked. And it still had to run, and bucking is hard. Bucking takes a lot of energy. So it got tired. It got tired faster because he took some of the piss and vinegar out of it before he got on it. And now he's going to take a whole bunch more piss and vinegar out of this horse and make it run and turn and run. And this horse is going to figure out, you know what? Bucking is not a good thing. I don't get a whole lot of payoff from bucking. I have to run hard. And he's making it, and running in a circle like this is very tough and takes a lot of muscle on the horse. They're leaning and turning. It's much harder for a horse to turn than to go in a straight line. That's why when you can make a horse turn, you can slow him down and control him. So in this round pen, you know he's flopping his arms? That's not because he's a bad rider. That's not because he's Jihan and he's like, I don't know how to ride and I've got loud hands. This is intentional. He's like, if you want to buck because I touch you with my back leg when I get on, or because I make you run, or because I tell you to do something you don't want to do, we're going to run and I'm going to give you all kind of reasons to buck. I'm going to flap my arms. I'm going to touch you on your butt. I'm going to make it to where no matter what happens when I'm on you, bucking is not a good thing, and it's never the right answer, and it doesn't get you any payoff. It just makes you tireder. That's what the horse is learning here. A lot of people will miss that, and the reason, and this, I'm not saying this is a good way to teach a horse. It would have been better had it was taught the right way, started the right way, and never learned to buck, and never got a payoff to buck. That would have been better. But once you let the stupid human teach all these bad lessons, someone else has to come in and unteach it. And usually that's harder on the horse. And it's not as good for the horse. So this guy's flapping and jumping and stopping and leaning back and loud. And he's kicking. And he's not trying to be quiet and soft. And he's not trying to, whoa, let me get off. Oh my God, he's bugging. Somebody help me. My horse is crazy. I better do an emergency dismount and just jump off. Because that's what women teach other women. Is you got to do an emergency dismount. It sounds great. It sounds safe. It sounds smart. Because women wear helmets. They're smart. And they have matching gear. They're smart. So they jump off horses when they buck. Because that's smart, right? No. It's very stupid. It teaches a horse a horrible lesson. It teaches a horse that when I want you off, I just buck. Emergency dismount is a crazy concept. But it's very popular in the woman horse world. Because it's safe, Rick. Because women are smarter and men are stupid for staying on because they could get hurt. And this is dangerous. And he doesn't have a helmet. See, women and men just have different aspects on what... To me and this guy, it's kind of fun to we'll let a horse try to buck you off. It's kind of a game. It's competition. He starts touching a horse on the rear. See him? He's like, oh. Because I guarantee you, she's probably told him, every time I touch him on the butt, he bucks. And this guy's like, he's not bucking now. I'm touching him on his butt. Why ain't he bucking now? Because every time he bucked before, when you touched him, you stopped and let him go. And you were afraid and you were scared and you were worried. That's why you had to hire someone else out to come and fix what you screwed up. This is a cute little horse, but he's just like any other horse. What the bad lessons he's been taught has to be untaught. And that's hard on him. So he's got to be tired and he's got to run. And he's working hard, and this horse is out of shape. And this horse has not been ridden this much, I guarantee you, since this woman has owned it. Unless someone else has ridden it. She's got someone else to ride it. You know, she bought it for a color so she could say, I own it. It's my horse. It's got great breeding. Look at the papers. Look at me. Look at me. And then I have to have someone else train it, someone else ride it, someone else show it. And then I'll take my picture with it and the ribbons. So, look. Guy did a lot of things right. He did some things that people will say is he doesn't know what he's doing. He's a wild, crazy cowboy, and these Western riders are rough and mean, and they don't have... I got no problem with what this guy's done so far. Like I said, he's wearing this horse out. He is teaching this horse a lesson. Dude, bucking is never the right answer. Bucking is hard. Bucking is the wrong way. The right way is to listen to me and let me sit on your back and do what I'm told. Because if you don't, guess what? You have to work harder. You're not going to be as comfortable. This horse wants to be comfortable. How does he want to be comfortable? He wants to stop running. He wants the rider to get off. He doesn't want to work. He doesn't want to do things he doesn't want to do. And before, all those things were solved by bucking. And I got what I wanted. The person got up. Guy got off on a horse on a good stop. And when a horse wasn't bucking, he didn't get off when he was scared. And when the horse was bucking, he didn't get off screaming, "Stop! Stop! Oh my God! Somebody! This horse is crazy! I gotta bail off! Look out! I'm jumping!" He didn't get off that way. So the horse learned, you know what? If I just let this guy ride me, he'll get off me. Bucking gets me nothing. Bucking is not the right answer. Guy gets back on him, gets his hat. Horse standing there like, damn, I'm just happy to stand still. I don't want to move. I don't want to buck. I don't want to do anything. I just want to relax. Guy got on him. Notice the horse didn't walk off that time. Did you notice that? Last time he got on him, the horse immediately walked off. This time the horse stood still. Well, Rick, maybe a fan butts of coconuts. The horse didn't move because he was tired and he was happy to stand still. Because he's comfort seeking. Because he wants release. And when I stand still, I'm not working. I'm not getting tired. It's easier. Horses will take the easy path, just like humans. So the easier thing to do is to stand still. The horse didn't walk off until this guy told him to move. See his hands and his legs? Move on. Then the horse goes, okay, if that's what you want me to do, I'll walk off. Didn't buck off. You notice when the cowboy got on this time, he didn't pussyfoot around. He actually rubbed his leg, I think, intentionally on this horse. I think he intentionally rubbed his leg here. Somebody may not see that, but I think this guy's been around a horse, and he was told that every time my leg touches his butt, he bucks. And that's why he was slapping him. That's why he tested him on the first time. And this is why he intentionally, I think this time, rubbed it. To see, you know what? Just because something touches your buck or your butt doesn't mean it's time to buck. So he intentionally, I think, rubbed his leg on his butt. Again, this guy's been around horses. He knows what's up. He knows who caused the problem. And he's doing everything the woman told him that he couldn't do. And he's doing everything that the woman said the horse wouldn't do. He's making the horse do. Horse is walking, trotting, turning. He's bouncing. His hands are loud. He's trying to get the horse to buck. Say, hey, you want a buck? Let's go. How did that work out last time? You want a buck? Let's go. Most women won't do that. They just think differently. And I'm not saying that it's because I hate women. We're just wired differently. Women aren't risk takers. Neither, even in a horse world, mares don't get out there and play and fight like the geldings because they don't want to get hurt. They want to raise their kids. They want to have babies. So when you do that, when you have that mindset, you do things differently in life. Geldings are always wanting to play and chase and get into mischief and go fight other horses and rear and bite. You don't see mares doing all that. Mares are like, I'll kick you if you don't leave me alone. Otherwise, just leave me alone. I want to eat. Maybe I'll let you breed me. I'll have a baby. I want to take care of my baby. Leave me alone. But for somehow, human women feel that that's somehow degrading and it's less and you shouldn't see them as that way. But humans are animals and we have different roles and we have different mindsets and we have different goals and objectives and we have different risk levels that we're willing to take. There's some guys that wouldn't get on a horse as bucking. But guys play hard sports, contact sports, and do things that are much more aggressive, and they take more risks, why their death rate's probably higher, because we're risk-seeking, and we find comfort in different ways than women. And there was an old psychological test when I was in college taking psychology. I remember it clearly. It was like, when your eyes dilate when you see things that are pleasing, and guys' eyes dilated the most when they saw naked, beautiful women. And women's eyes dilated the most when they saw a baby. And that's just nothing that was planned, and nobody studied it, and nobody said, no, that's not true, and we're going to make eyes do something different because eyes are somehow sexist, and that's not right that women should see things different than men, and we should all be... None of that crap mattered, okay? Guys and women are different. This guy handles the horse a lot differently than the owner does, And that's why he got a lot different results. Horse doesn't care whether he's a woman or a man. The horse only cares what you do. Not what you say, not what you feel, not what you hope, not what you wish for, not what you want. It only cares what you do. And until you get that, you're not going to be successful with horses. All right. I thought this was a good little video. Good little horse. We'll end that there.